Guru Busters!
Welcome back. In the last video, we started diving into the world of Monte Carlo simulations, and we saw firsthand how variance can completely mess with your perception of betting success. We ran 1,000 bets, and despite using negative value odds, we saw results that could either leave you with big profits or big losses. That's the brutal reality of betting. Often, pure randomness is in the driver's seat. And this is where fake gurus cash in. They count on you confusing luck for a winning system. They will tell you their system is a guaranteed winner, and when you have a few lucky wins, you start to believe it. But it's all smoke and mirrors. Variance tricking you into thinking you found something that works when you haven't. Now, before we go any further, I have to remind you these videos also serve as a tutorial for making Monte Carlo simulations in Excel. If you didn't watch the last video, you need to go back and check it out first, because otherwise you won't fully understand what we are doing in Excel today. Trust me, this will all make a lot more sense if you follow along from the start. So today we are picking up right where we left off. We are going to dig deeper into this and try to untangle the web of luck versus skill in betting. Because if you are serious about making money in the long term, you need to understand how variance affects your results and how to separate the noise from the real edge. Let's get into it. As promised, we are going to level up our spreadsheet. Last time we had 20 simultaneous runs of 1000 bets, but Excel can handle much more. We are going to easily simulate 10,000 runs. Extending this is simple. Since I have done it before, I know we need to track or copy the formulas until column NTU. Highlight all cells up to column NTU and paste it. Now think about this. Excel is handling 1000 bets across 10,000 runs. That's 10 million calculations simultaneously. And it's still running pretty fast. With this, we can now get more valuable insights than we did with the performance chart last time. Instead of just looking at individual outcomes, we can create a probability distribution of the possible results. To do that, we will select our newly generated 10,000 profit loss values, go to the Insert tab, and choose a histogram graph. Isn't that beautiful again? Now we can see the entire range of possible outcomes and how likely they are. We can press F9 for a fresh set of 10,000 runs. Just a heads up, Excel sometimes messes up the scale on the x-axis, so we might need to manually adjust it. So what do we see here? Pure randomness can result in anything from a huge loss to a huge win. But most likely we will end up somewhere in between. I'll add a line at the break-even point. On average, we lose. But surprisingly, there is still a significant probability of winning. Even so, each of our bets has negative value. Let's calculate the average profit loss. This is simple. We will just use the average function on our results. If we press F9 a few times, you will notice that with 10,000 runs, the average fluctuates slightly. But it's good enough to give us a clear idea of what to expect. Now, you might be asking, why don't we just calculate exactly what our expected profit or loss should be over 1000 bets? And you'd be right. We can easily calculate that exact value without needing a simulation. However, for other values, especially more complex ones, it's either very difficult or even impossible to calculate them directly. That's where simulations come in. They give us approximate values. They don't need to be 100% precise to provide crucial insights. But let's calculate the actual expected profit of our bets to check how far off our simulation might be. We add another column and calculate the expected value per bet. With the probability of winning, which is the reciprocal of the true odds, we get odds minus 1 times our stake. And with 1 minus the probability of winning, we lose our stake. Now let's press F9 a few times. Wait a second, shouldn't this value stay stable? No, and here's why. Each of our odds has a different expected value, and every time we generate new odds, we are essentially changing the expected value over all bets. That's a bit inelegant, but we can fix it by simply copy-pasting the current odds as static values in the same column. After all, we only need to set the odds once since we just wanted to implement different odds in the first place. If you don't mind, and as it really doesn't make a big difference, I suggest you simply skip this step, so later you will still be able to change the odds range. Otherwise, you'd have to put in the formula again. Now that the expected profit loss is stable, we will see only the simulated profit fluctuating. And we can see that our simulation isn't far off from the real expected value. But what is this probability? The probability that we will end up profitable. Calculating that exactly isn't so straightforward anymore. And this is where Monte Carlo simulations really shine. Sometimes we don't know how to calculate something precisely. Sometimes it's actually impossible. And let's be real, sometimes we are just too lazy or too dumb to figure out a mathematical solution. Fortunately, we can use simulations to get the answer we are after. In our case, we simply count how many times we ended up with a value greater than zero. A basic Excel function, COUNTIF, handles this easily. Our range of values, in quotation marks, greater zero, and then divide that by the total number of runs. Press F9 a few times and we get a robust result. Around 38%. Once again, this result is pretty counterintuitive. It's hard to wrap your head around it. Even as a pro, you constantly underestimate the impact of variance. We are betting with a negative value over 1000 bets, which could take some people years to complete. And yet there is still a decent chance that we could end up winning. But actually, aren't we more interested in knowing how likely we are to win if we do have positive value? Obviously, if we set the commission rate to minus 2%, we will see the opposite results compared to the negative value case. Let's try looking at bets with more value. Setting the commission rate to minus 10% would mean getting odds of 199 for a bet that should be 190. That's pretty good value, especially pre-play. So how does that turn out? Even with such a strong edge, there's still about a 7.5% chance you will end up losing. How frustrating is that? You've worked your ass off, built a solid, profitable system, and yeah, it could pay off. But if you are unlucky, not only does all your hard work amount to nothing, you end up paying for it with a loss. Now that we have built this spreadsheet, feel free to experiment with it. You can test the impact of using different odds ranges, higher or lower value bets, or varying the number of bets. Want to go further? Extend the spreadsheet and try 2000 bets, 5000 bets, or even 10,000 bets, and see when Excel starts hitting its limits. In the next video, we will tackle a popular question using this spreadsheet. How many bets do you need to determine if your bets actually had an edge? I've seen plenty of wrong answers to this question online, so let's dig into it and figure out the real answer together. Should be pretty interesting. If you are enjoying these videos and finding them useful, make sure to hit the like button and subscribe so you don't miss out on the next deep dive. And if you know someone who needs a reality check on their betting, share this with them. Let's spread the truth. Until next time.
Guru Busters!